Well done, boys. The last job went fine. There's no evidence or witnesses left against us. Thanks to your persuasive methods, they won't even squeak.
Thanks, boss. We try to make you happy.
Well, you certainly did. But today we're here for something else. Paulie has a pretty interesting proposal.
Well, I met a guy from Kentucky, William Gates. Everyone knows that Kentucky makes the best home-brewed whiskey. Well, anyway, this guy almost threw up when he tried the whiskey which Morello sells here. When he gave me a drink of this stuff, they brew back there, forget about it. I won't drink anything else. So I asked him about it, right? He said it was no problem and that he could deliver me as much as I wanted. You know, I got jazzed thinking about the dough we'd make on it. Well, I ordered a truckload of it. I said to myself, if it catches on here, we can make a bigger deal later.
It would certainly be a good replacement for the loss of our Canadian. I like it. Nice one.
Me too.
So we're gonna pick up some beautiful booze.
I'm already looking forward to it.
Where are they hiding it?
They'll meet us in the big parking garage.
We have to be more careful than we were before. You'll get to the place by car with two other boys. They'll be your escort on the way back. You three pick up the truck and take it to our warehouse in Hoboken. The boys are already out in the yard waiting in the car. And bring me back a bottle so I can finally drink something decent.
Count on it, boss. Get in. We're going for some medicine.
Here, Tom. This might come in useful.
Thanks.
Wait for us here, boys. We'll be back in a little while. We drive out, follow after us. Then, we'll have a shot at the warehouse.
Sure, boss.
Hello, 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 people, and welcome to VGB playing Mafia. This is part 13. And what a change of pace. We don't even get to pick a car or go and see Vincenzo or anything. We're just like taken right fucking here. What the fuck is this? Bullshit. Anyway, yeah, I'm not gonna lie. I have already tried to record this part already. Things went a bit dodgy. It annoyed the fuck out of me. And I gave up. So yeah, I'm back at it. I got to like literally just the first part of the level, so I didn't get very far at all. Sort of not like spoiled myself or anything. Although I have already played this game, so it's not like it matters much anyway. One thing I'd like to note. Oh god, that's probably doesn't sound too good. Anyway, one thing I'd like to point out is starting with the last part. You may have noticed a huge. Huge fucking increase in quality, and well, that's because, good news people, I have now got the ability to render video correctly and effectively, and now I can upload really nice crisp quality video instead of the shit that I usually do, which has like no bitrate. So hey ho. Also, it means I can make edits and cuts and whatnot wherever I need to, so that's always nice. But yeah, anyway, we're here with part 13. Let's get on with this shit. So, first thing we're doing. Alrighty. First thing we're doing is we're finding Bill. And just to cut it down, you can assume he'd probably be on the top floor because that's where these dodgy deals always go down, right? But yeah, anyway, here he is. Get some of that booze and shit, yo. Where's the booze?
Hey there, Bill. It's good to see you again.
Hey, Paulie.
These are my partners who are good friends. They like the idea of working together. And they also like first-rate whiskey, which yours certainly is.
That it is.
The main thing is that Don Salieri likes it, too. And since he's financing the whole deal, here's your first payment for the goods.
Give Mr. Salieri my regards. I'm always happy to do business with people like him.
You should be, Bill. You could hit it big with this. If this small delivery works out for us, we'll order a lot more next time.
Take cover!
What's going on?
Jesus, who are they?
Fire! Kill the bastards!
Those are some fucking long-ass range shotguns, holy fuck. So yeah, of course, it can't go as simple as you'd expect or hope. Some bullshit has to happen. Oh god, my aim's shite. See, when I was last doing this, because I'd played this part so many times over, my aim became like fucking amazing. So the first thing you'll immediately notice is Sam, because he's using a shotgun, is a fucking moron. And will run head first into deadly situations. I just got distracted by my fucking, by the outside world. Because for once I'm not playing this in the middle of the night. And so I can see outside and things are going past the window and it distracts the fuck out of me. I have to decide which way is better. If I go down here, things are pretty shit. But I'll try it anyway. Auto reload. There we go. Oh shit. I forgot it does that. It's not like COD where your guns magically reappear in your clip that you just dropped. Nope, you lose whatever's in your clip in this game. Balls. There's a lot more guys down here than last time. And there's also a bunch up here as well. That's fine. Why are they coming up? For God's sake, they didn't do that last time. There's no health around here anywhere, is there? Oh, fuck. Why would there be? Oh, bollocks! There we go. Yep. By the way, if you expected the game to checkpoint where I meet the fucking guy, you've got another thing coming because they want you to go all the way back up here and talk to him again. And although it isn't much, it's a bit annoying still. I don't want to have to do that. Go on, game. Just let me reload where I was.
yourself.
Oh, for God's sake, guys. Getting cover! What the fuck are you doing? Please blow up.
Come out and fight like a man.
Why does it do that? Ah. So yeah, depending on how long this shit takes, a bunch of this might end up cut out. Where? What the fuck is going on? What are you doing? Why is he down here? Why? Oh, for fuck's sake. Thank you, game. This is exactly what I needed. This isn't a good idea, is it? Why aren't you getting in? Oh fuck. This is so not good. There's no way I'm surviving this shit. Well, they're not anyway. What the fuck? Move! Guys, really? Why can I not shoot? This game is fucking stupid. It shows that my reticule is aiming at the barrel, but he's actually shooting the fucking car. Why? What a fucking... Oh. Why can he hit me, but I can't hit him? What the fuck? Why does Paulie manage to get through everything unscathed? And then Sam's just like, look at me, I'm fucking dead. Oh, why can't I see? What is going on? Don't come down there. Don't go down there. Oh, for fuck's sake. I'm so fucking done. I'm getting killed by a shotgun that's halfway across a fucking parking lot.
Oh, stop that.
Fucking run in front of a gunfire then, you stupid fucking mong. Or just, you know, crouch in front of me constantly! What are we supposed to do here? There's guys everywhere, isn't there? Fuck me! fuck! What the fuck? What am I supposed to do? Really? From that far away? Really? With a shotgun? Oh my god, Lord. Oh, Jesus Christ. Please move. Please move away. Please move away. That car's gonna blow up. Oh, for fuck's sake. It's over. Why are these... Oh, invincible. You know what would have made this a lot better? If I could just tell Paulie or Sam to move the fuck away. Instead of being complete fucking retards. Can I go now? Tell me I'm done. Please let me out.
I still got some work to do.
What? What work have you got to do? Where was he? Where was he? WHERE WAS HE?! Game, please. Why am I not hitting this guy? Thank you. I swear to God, if I keep shooting... If I keep shooting the fucking car, I'm gonna get so pissed off. Just raise the gun a bit, for fuck's sake. Get the fuck out of my way. Kill the guy behind you, please! Do I have to... Why is he not... Oh my god. Oh, do I have to clear out this whole place or what? What do I need? What do I need to do? I don't get it. What am I supposed to
do?
There
isn't time for that.
What am I supposed to do? What? I guess I have to kill everyone. I don't...
Bill's kicked it.
Fuck me.
What the hell was that, Paulie? Who were those hoods? How should I know?
Okay, okay. Well, we can't hang around here waiting for more of them to show up. Let's get the truck and get the hell out of here. Tom, you drive. I'll follow behind in one of the other cars.
I don't even know where you are, Sam. I'm not gonna lie. Alright, then I guess we'll get in the truck. Oh, fuck me, that was the most annoying. I don't know how much of that's been cut out, by the way. But fuck me, I hope a lot of it, because you don't want to hear me raging. Because I got really pissed just now. Holy fuck. Alright, let's get the fuck out of here. Am I leaving? All right. Whew. Jesus Christ. Oh, that was such a joke. It was a lot easier without my frames limited through recording, so right. Ah. Why did it? Yeah. Oh my god, how many cars are chasing us? Where are we going? To the warehouse. I was about to go to Salieri's bar, so it's a good thing to check that. This is a new song. You run your mouth and I run my business, brother. You start in telling me you're my pal and end up telling me how to handle my gal. You run your mouth and I run my business, brother. Oh Jesus, why are they so fast? Oh no. Fuck. We gotta go pretty fast. Maybe worry about the guys. Why is he doing that? What the fuck was that? Oh, I'm dead. I can't because the game just fucking bullshitted me over and made me do turns that I didn't even do. Fuck me. The fuck was that? Yeah, worry about the speeding car opposed to the fucking.
It's stuck on us like glue.
Oh, Jesus fucking bullshit. Fucking.
Yes. I don't want to die.
Yeah. Unless they shut out my tire, which fine, I can get over. But fuck me, what the fuck? That really pissed me off. Oh no. Just tell me I can lose him. I'm not gonna lose him, am I? And it's gonna be like, you can't come into the warehouse with a wanted level. Lol.
Okay, we did it.
Why? Oh, fucking hell.
So it looks like Merla got in the way of things again, boss.
We can't seem to shake off this bad luck.
Boys, you won't believe this, but it's completely the other way around. The only one who really had bad luck this time was Morello.
What?
I found out who our Mr. Gates really was.
And?
Gates was never really from Kentucky. He was a small-time thief who stole the goods from Morello and wanted to sell them to us. Morello doesn't think that he almost stopped our deal, but that we pinched a truckload of his most expensive whiskey. I bet that bastard's happy now.
Unbelievable! Well, that worked out just fine. Let's drink to that.
To another success, boys. Salud.
The end of Prohibition in 33. You probably weren't too happy, huh? The end of the good old days.
Yeah, not too happy, but it wasn't all bad. Eventually, I did get married to Sarah and had a daughter. It was a good time. But life went on in business. We made a huge amount of dough during Prohibition, which we invested into new deals. A lot of them were legitimate. We had regular firms like construction, transport, restaurants. We ran labor unions. And of course, there was gambling, betting, the lotteries. We actually did really well. We just tried to stay out of drugs, even if it wasn't always easy.
Come on, business is business, right?
You're way off there. The Cosa Nostra ain't no patties or Chinamen. With drugs comes big money and even bigger problems. When someone has a problem with the cops because of drugs, he does the sensible thing. He admits it. If his family catches him, they rub him out. Drugs are taboo.
So what? There's some kind of grand poobah passing judgment?
Something like that. The leading families choose a boss of bosses. They sort out the big problems and set the rules of the game.
So, criminals who break the law have their own courts that judge them? That's just great.
Laws aren't changeless, holy words. Every country in the world has their own. It's just somebody with a lot of power applying their own will. It depends on the person whether they'll serve someone else blindly or apply their own will. Why should the Don be restrained? The Mafia prevailed through Prohibition with its own laws. A handful of poor, uneducated immigrants from Sicily were stronger than all the laws, courts, and police here in the States. That took some doing.
What? With murder? With the suffering they caused?
Come on. You think that the Mafia just murders innocent people? The Mafia punishes those who break laws. And the majority of your laws, too. Unfortunately, we can't put anyone in jail or fine them. Everybody who comes and works for us knows what to expect if he breaks the rules. People lie and steal, and there are lots of criminals here who get unbelievable pleasure when they steal from the mob, as well as the mafiosos who get pleasure from cheating the state.
And what about all the payoffs, robberies, and raids, huh?
Hey, the cops ain't no saints, neither. No Don encourages his men to go around harming people. And what other people do on their own isn't our concern. And as for payoffs, most people come to the Don for help and advice on their own. And they'll pay gladly for it. The Don is an esteemed person, but not every Don is like Salieri. That's the truth.
There you go. Your system works, but you know why? Because you're a bunch of selfish murderers. And you only care about your own gain. All your efforts are spent ensuring that you live like pigs in shit. That's why you're so successful. You're only looking out for yourselves. We look out after everybody. A few cops have to ensure law and order for all, and that's a much harder job.
That's true. But you can easily leave the Don outside your protection. He'll watch his own back.
And what about you? What are you sitting here for?